Hello dear students, in last lecture we have already started this paper number 6, that is applied microbiology. And in previous video lectures we have started that first unit, that is air microbiology. तो अभी जो भी हमारा टॉपिक हमने शुरू किया है एयर माइक्रोबायोलॉजी, व्हाट एवर दैट रिमेनिंग पोर्शन इज देयर इन दिस एयर माइक्रोबायोलॉजी दैट आई विल टेक लेटर ऑन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट हियर सेकंड टॉपिक दैट इज वाटर माइक्रोबायोलॉजी. लास्ट लेक्चर में हमने एयर माइक्रोबायोलॉजी ये टॉपिक ऑलरेडी शुरू किया है और उसमें एक दो पॉइंट हमने कवर किए, लेकिन अभी आज जो टॉपिक मैं शुरू करने वाला हूँ वो सेकंड टॉपिक शुरू करने वाला हूँ. एंड द नेम ऑफ दिस सेकंड टॉपिक इज वाटर माइक्रोबायोलॉजी. और एयर माइक्रोबायोलॉजी का जो भी पोर्शन बाकी है आई विल टेक और आई विल कवर दैट पोर्शन आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस वाटर माइक्रोबायोलॉजी. सो टुडे वी विल सी और वी विल स्टार्ट दैट सेकंड टॉपिक एंड द नेम ऑफ दैट सेकंड टॉपिक और यूनिट इज वाटर माइक्रोबायोलॉजी. फ्रेंड्स, अगर आपने ये यूट्यूब चैनल सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया हो, दैट इज माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नप्ते, तो जरूर इसे सब्सक्राइब करिए, क्योंकि जो भी मैं वीडियो यहाँ पे अपलोड करने वाला हूँ, सो आफ्टर अपलोडिंग दैट वीडियो यू विल गेट नोटिफिकेशन. सो सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल. अगर आपको वीडियो अच्छा लगा है, टीचिंग कुछ अच्छी लगी है, समझ में आया है, तो ये वीडियो शेयर करिए आपके फ्रेंड्स को. देन कमेंट्स ऑन दिस वीडियोस. एंड अगर आपको वीडियो पसंद आया है तो लाइक कीजिए, अगर नहीं पसंद आया तो डिसलाइक कीजिए. बट डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल दैट इज माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नप्ते. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट दिस यूनिट 2 दैट इज वाटर माइक्रोबायोलॉजी. ये सेकंड यूनिट में हम टोटल 7 पॉइंट्स कवर करने वाले हैं. द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज दैट इज टाइप्स ऑफ वाटर. Then we will see sources of microorganisms in water. Then third point is index of water pollution. Next point is different indicator microorganisms and coliform bacteria. Then next we will see microbiological examination of water. Then we will see waterborne diseases. Next point we will going to cover here, that is treatment and safety of potable water, that is drinking water. तो ये 7 पॉइंट हम इस सेकंड यूनिट में कवर करने वाले हैं. सो वन बाय वन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट हियर. लेकिन आज के जो वीडियो लेक्चर में हम पॉइंट कवर करने वाले हैं, दैट फर्स्ट 2 पॉइंट्स वी आर गोइंग टू कवर हियर. वन इज टाइप्स ऑफ वाटर एंड द सेकंड वन इज सोर्सेस ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स इन वाटर. So, see this diagram here. It is showing the availability of water on the Earth planet. हमारे Earth में water का जो भी percentage है, इसी diagram में हमें समझ में आएगा यहाँ पे. So here, अगर हम ground water consider करेंगे, तो ये 30.1%. उसके बाद other sources जो है, वो है 0.9%. Then these swamps, rivers and broadly that lakes, they consist of this 87% here. Then later on, this surface water, it constitute about 0.30%. It is a very less quantity of surface water is available on Earth, and the large portions of water on this Earth planet, it is covered by seawater, or we can say here that ice caps and glaciers, which constitute about 68.6 7% here. And this portion, it constitute about this saline or ocean, that is 97%. And here fresh water also there is presence of, that is 3% here. So this is the availability of water on the earth. Then, so what is meant by water microbiology? Just some introduction we will see about this water microbiology. So ye water microbiology kya hai? So water microbiology is a scientific study of all biological aspects of microorganisms such as bacteria, archaea, viruses, fungi, parasites and protozoa which are present in water. वाटर में जो भी माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म अलग अलग प्रकार के प्रेजेंट है, जिसमें बैक्टीरिया आते हैं, आर्किया है, वायरसेस है, फंजा है, पैरासाइट्स है, प्रोटोजोआ है, तो इसकी जो स्टडी वहां पे की जाती है, दैट टाइप और साइंटिफिक स्टडी ऑफ ऑल दीज माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म इट इज कॉल्ड एज वाटर माइक्रोबायोलॉजी. एंड ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट वाटर इट इज अ बेसिक नीड ऑफ लाइफ and it is also a universal solvent. So you know this thing here, it is basic need of life and it is a universal solvent. And whatever that biochemical processes, these are taking place in all living organisms. So these are taking place in presence of enzymes. So these all enzymes catalyzing these important biochemical reactions, it requires water for their activity or for their functioning. This is a very important function of water for all living things. And in addition to this function, that water, it also acts as a source of oxygen as well as hydrogen, which is required for the growth of microorganisms. At the same time, this water, it acts as a source of hydrogen in photosynthesis. So these are the some introductory part of this water microbiology, and here these are the importance of this water for living things. Now the next point we are going to cover here, that is types of water. Water ke kaun se prakar hai? So this water, it is present in nature in three different types. Hamare nature mein water teen prakar mein present hai. Ek hai ground water, dusra hai surface water and tisra hai atmospheric water. So one by one we are going to see here. So first one is here, that is the first one, ground water. अगर ये डायग्राम में आप देखोगे यहाँ पे, तो ये बारिश जो है, so this rain water, it get infiltrated here. मतलब जमीन में वो जो भी वाटर है वो वहां पे चला जाएगा. So and some water from this layer, which is known as unsaturated zone. So it is absorbed by or taken by these plants on the soil. So this here there are presence of this sand and gravel, and from this that water goes deep inside the earth, which forms the that water table here. Later on there is a water table is formed. So this is a aquifer. Aquifer means it is a layer consisting in which that water is absorbed or stored in presence or in between that soil or that gravels or that sands. So this is a water table. Now below water table, whatever that water is present here, it is present between the that silty layers as well as between the sand and gravel aquifer. So that, and later on it is also present in the fractured rock aquifer. So this water, it is called as groundwater, and this zone, it is known as groundwater zone. So yahan pe jo bhi water yahan pe present is layer mein, see this layer is here. So this water which is present in this layer, it is called as ground water. Aur uske upar ka jo hai, actually this water is here, it is a surface water. But this surface water, it fills this ground water zone, and now that water is called as ground water. So this is the diagram showing this surface water as well as this ground water here. So we will see some points about this groundwater. So the surface water, now it moves in the downward through the unsaturated zones. Surface water jo bhi present hai, it moves in downward direction through these unsaturated zones, and that is between the very small pores as well as cracks which are present in soil, or that may be of sand or rock, and then it reaches to the water table. So this table, or below this water table, there is a presence of that water that is called as ground water. जैसे हमने यहाँ पे देखा है कि that water it goes or it infiltrate through this unsaturated zone and then it reaches to the water table. So the below this water table, whatever this water is present here, it is called as ground water. इसे हम बोलते हैं ground water. So this ground water it is found underground in the cracks as well as in the small spaces of the soil, sand and rocks, and it is stored in as well as it moves slowly through the geological formations of the soil, sand and rocks. Now it is the filtration of this water takes place through these pores of soils, and that's why this groundwater it is the pure form of water. So therefore it is a safest source of water for drinking purposes, because it gets filtered through the pores of that soils or sands or that rocks. This groundwater it helps grow our food, because whatever that water is available to the crops or plants, it is from this groundwater source. And near about 64% of groundwater it is used for the irrigation purposes to grow the crops. So this groundwater it is an important component in many industrial processes, because that water is also utilized for industrial processes. So that's why it is very important. And this groundwater it is also a source of recharge for lakes, rivers and wetlands. मतलब जो भी lakes है, rivers है और wetlands है, इसमें अगर पानी कहाँ से आता है, तो एक तो वहां से बारिश की वजह से आता है, और अगर बारिश वहां पे नहीं है तो that sources that may be rivers, lakes or these wetlands, these are filled or recharged by this groundwater. Then the microorganisms as well as suspended particles, these are actually removed by filtration through rock layers and soil pores. जैसे मैंने पहले आपको यहाँ पे बताया कि surface water जो ground में जाता है, soil में जाता है, earth में जाता है, that get filtered through these rock layers as well as soil pores. But it may contains many minerals such as fluorides, and these fluorides generally these are harmful for the human health, which causes fluorosis affecting the teeth generally in children's. See, this is the diagram here. If that fluorides are present in higher concentration or quantity in that water, so that higher concentration of these fluorides or these minerals in water, it causes fluorosis in children's, and that teeth becomes like this here. See, these are the affected teeth due to excess concentration of these fluorides in that groundwater. See, these are the activities of microorganisms which takes place in the groundwater. For example, this microorganism they transform organic carbon to carbon dioxide. Then the use of oxygen when sufficient carbon is available for growth. Then they transform nitrogen between oxidized, that is nitrate, and reduced ammonia or nitrogen gas forms. Then also transforms iron between oxidized, that is Fe3+ and reduced Fe2+ forms. Then it transform sulfur between oxidized, that is sulfate, and reduced forms. It produces methane. Then the microorganisms present in groundwater, they degrade pesticides, fuels and other organic contaminants. And these microorganisms present in groundwater, they affect the distribution and solubility of some metals such as arsenic, uranium, like that. So these are the activities of microorganisms present in groundwater. The second type of water is surface water. So surface water is any body of water which is found on the earth's surface, including both the salt water in the ocean and the fresh water in rivers, streams and lakes. सरफेस वाटर ये अर्थ पे प्रेजेंट कौन सी भी एक वाटर की ऐसी बॉडी है जो कि सॉल्ट वाटर जो ओशन में प्रेजेंट है या फिर फ्रेश वाटर जो रिवर्स में स्ट्रीम्स में या लेक्स लेक्स में प्रेजेंट है, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज सरफेस वाटर। एंड प्रेसिपिटेशन एंड वाटर रन ऑफ दे फीड द बॉडीज ऑफ सरफेस वाटर। सो जो प्रेसिपिटेशन होता है या फिर वाटर रन ऑफ होता है, बोथ ऑफ दीज दे एड वाटर इन द बॉडीज ऑफ दीज सरफेस वाटर दैट मे बी रिवर्स स्ट्रीम्स और लेक्स। एंड इवेपोरेशन एंड सीपेज ऑफ दिस वाटर इन टू द ग्राउंड इट कॉजेस वाटर बॉडीज टू लूज वाटर बिकॉज बोथ ऑफ दिस प्रोसेस दैट मे बी इवेपोरेशन एज वेल एज दैट सीपेज ऑफ वाटर इन द ग्राउंड इट विल कॉज द लूजिंग ऑफ वाटर फ्रॉम दिस डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सरफेस वाटर बॉडीज। एंड देर आर थ्री डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सरफेस वाटर, वन इज पेरिनियल, सेकेंड वन इज इफीमेरल एंड थर्ड वन इज मैन मेड। सो पेरिनियल वाटर और विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज परमानेंट वाटर, इट इज वन टाइप ऑफ सरफेस वाटर विच परसिस्ट और प्रेजेंट थ्रू आउट द ईयर एंड इट इज रिप्लेनिश्ड विथ ग्राउंड वाटर वेन देर इज लिटिल प्रेसिपिटेशन। जब बारिश कम हो जाती है तब ये जो पेरिनियल वाटर है और जिसे जिसको हम परमानेंट वाटर बोलते हैं दैट गेट रिप्लेनिश्ड बाय दिस दैट वाटर। सेकंड टाइप इज इफीमेरल और सेमी परमानेंट वाटर। सो इट इज अगेन अ टाइप ऑफ सरफेस वाटर एंड इट एग्जिस्ट फॉर ओनली पार्ट ऑफ द ईयर और फॉर शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन एंड इट इंक्लूड्स दैट स्मॉल क्रीक्स देन इट इंक्लूड्स लगूंस एज वेल एज वाटर होल्स। एंड द थर्ड टाइप ऑफ वाटर और सरफेस वाटर इज मैन मेड वाटर विच इज फाउंड इन आर्टिफिशियल स्ट्रक्चर्स सच एज डैम्स लेक्स और दैट कंस्ट्रक्टेड वेटलैंड्स और वाटर बॉडीज। सो दीज आर द टाइप्स ऑफ सरफेस वाटर। नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज दैट इज अबाउट द जस्ट वन मिनट This surface water generally contaminated with microorganisms which are coming from the soil and any waste material which is added in the soil or in that water. So therefore this water or surface water it is more contaminated as compared to the groundwater. And this surface water it generally consists of different types of organic as well as inorganic components which are present in the dissolved forms and these are called as total dissolved solids of the water. This water it is widely contaminated from different sources and therefore it consists of different types of microorganisms as well as physical and chemical agents which are harmful to the human being. So this surface water it consists of microorganisms that may be pathogenic or non-pathogenic and in addition to these microorganisms it consists of physical and chemical agents which are harmful to the human health. So the number and type of microorganisms they differ according to the source of that microorganisms or according to the geographical and biological conditions. Is surface water mein kaun se type ke microorganisms present rahenge ya fir kitne rahenge that depends on the source of that water which contaminate this surface water here. Then the third type of water is called as atmospheric water. So in the atmosphere that water it exists in three different forms. One is the gaseous form that is present in the form of water vapors and these are formed due to the evaporation. Then the second form which is present in atmosphere it is a liquid form that is present in the form of droplets of rain. And third type of form that is called as liquid water which is present or which coats the solid particles and it is also present in the solid form that is in the form of snow and ice. And the microflora of this atmospheric water, it is contributed by air. Because whatever that microorganisms are present in air or in atmosphere, that same microorganisms, they get added in this atmospheric water. And nearly all of the water is located in the lowest layer of atmosphere, and that lowest layer or the nearest layer, it is called as troposphere. The water which is present in atmosphere, it is present in variable amounts, and that is ranges from 0% to 4%. Then microorganisms present in air, which are attached to these dust particles, and these are washed by rainwater. Therefore, the water that drops on the surface, it is generally free of microorganisms, and it does not contain any type of minerals which are essential for the growth of human or animals or plants, and it is a tasteless like a distilled water. So this is the atmospheric water. So here we completed that three different types of waters here. One is groundwater, second one was surface water, and that third one was atmospheric water. Now the second point in this unit is that is sources of microorganisms in water. Water mein microorganisms kahan se enter hote hain, kaun se sources hai, so that we are going to see in this second topic or second point. See this diagram here. This shows the different sources of microorganisms in water. So one is soil here, then second one atmosphere or air, then next one sewage, then next one decaying organic matter, and fifth source of microorganisms of water is human and animal activities. So that one by one we are going to see here. So let's start with sources of microorganisms in water, and that is the first source is soil. So all of you know that soil is a rich source of microorganisms. अगर हम अलग अलग सोर्स कंपेयर करेंगे तो सबसे ज्यादा माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स ये सॉइल में प्रेजेंट है. सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज अ रिच सोर्स ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. 1 ग्राम ऑफ सॉइल अप्रोक्सीमेटली इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ बैक्टीरिया दैट इज फ्रॉम 10^8 टू 10^9. दिस इज द नंबर ऑफ बैक्टीरिया प्रेजेंट इन 1 ग्राम ऑफ सॉइल. Then the number of actinomycetes in 1 gram of soil, it is about 10^5 to 10^8. Then the number of fungi in 1 gram of soil consists of 10^5 to 10^6. Then microalgae ranges from 10^3 to 10^6. Then protozoa 10^3 to 10^5. Then nematodes 10^1 to 10^2, and other invertebrate organisms which are present in soil, it ranges about 10^3 to 10^5. So this is about the different types of microorganisms present in 1 gram of soil. And a square meter of soil, it generally consists of 30 to 300 earthworms. So there are more organisms in a gram of a soil then there are human beings which are present on the earth. अगर हम population compare करेंगे human being का और microorganisms का, अगर हमने 1 gram soil ली, and if you are considering the population of human being on whole earth, so the number of microorganisms will be more only in 1 gram of soil. And the bacteria that are most abundant microorganisms present in the soil with a population of 10^10 to 10^11 or less than this, that is this one here. So and there are generally 6000 to 50000 species per gram of soil. To ye ek statistics hai, estimation hai number ka microorganisms ke jo bhi present hai 1 gram of soil mein. And all types of microorganisms which are present in soil, that may be bacteria, these are actinomycetes, these are fungi, algae, protozoa. So each of these groups of microorganisms, they have characteristics that define them and their functions in the soil. ये जो अलग अलग प्रकार के microorganisms है, इसके functions भी soil में अलग अलग प्रकार के है. And when the atmospheric water reaches to the surface of soil, so these soil microorganisms, they get added into the water. That's why that soil, it act as a major source of microorganisms, and it is particularly for the surface of water. In this way, that water get contaminated by different types of microorganisms, which includes pathogenic microorganisms, and therefore such type of water, it become a reason for different types of waterborne diseases. See, these are the soil microorganisms, and here these are examples. So the bacteria which are present in soil, that includes Agrobacterium, then Bacillus, Clostridium, Pseudomonas. Actinomycetes includes that Nocardia, Streptomyces. Fungi includes Aspergillus, Fusarium, Alternaria, Cladosporium. Then soil algae includes Anabaena, then Oscillatoria, Nostoc. Protozoa includes that is Colpoda, then Nematodes, then Pleurotrichia and Heteromita. And that bacteriophages which are present in soil, that includes T4 bacteriophages. Then second sources of microorganisms in water, that is nothing but atmosphere or air. So actually the air does not consist of any types of nutrients and it does not have moisture. Therefore it just acts as a transport medium for the different types of microorganisms. And whatever that different types of microorganisms are present in air, generally they are spores of bacteria as well as of molds, and from that air they get added into the water which contaminate that water. These airborne particles, these are the major cause of respiratory ailments or diseases of the humans, which causes allergies, then asthma, then as well as different types of pathogenic infections of the respiratory system. And these airborne fungal spores, these are also important agents for plant diseases and for the dissemination of many common saprophytic fungi. So in this way, that air, it acts as a source of microorganisms. See, these are the microorganisms present in air that consist of bacteria. It consists of different types of fungi. Then there is the allergens are also present, which causes allergies, and that viruses are also present here. So these are the microorganisms present in the air, and all these microorganisms, they get added into the water. So that's why that air, it is one of the important source of microorganisms in water. Then the third source is that is sewage. So sewage, it is a used water by communities, hospitals and industries. Matlab industries se, humare community se ya hospitals se, jo bhi use kiya hua water release kiya jata hai, that water it is called as sewage. And it consists of different types of organic as well as inorganic compounds in addition to that pathogenic as well as non-pathogenic microorganisms. And leakage of drinking water pipelines usually results in the mixing of sewage. तो हम काफी जगह पे देखते हैं कि दैट वाटर पाइपलाइंस दीज आर लीक्ड. सो फ्रॉम दिस लीकेज दैट सीवेज एंटर्स इनटू दिस वाटर पाइपलाइंस, ड्रिंकिंग वाटर पाइपलाइंस, एंड दे विल कंटेमिनेट दैट वाटर. एंड देयरफॉर इट इज वेरी एसेंशियल टू कीप दिस सुटेबल डिस्टेंस बिटवीन वाटर पाइपलाइन एंड सीवेज डिस्पोजेबल एरिया, सो दैट वी कैन अवॉइड द कंटेमिनेशन ऑफ दिस ड्रिंकिंग वाटर, thereby preventing the different types of waterborne diseases. See, this is the composition of sewage here. Sewage, it consists of water 99.9%, then solids 0.1%, and that solids includes organic components which constitute about 70%, inorganic constitute about 30%, organic mein aata hai proteins 65%, carbohydrate 25%, and fats 10%. And inorganic components mein aata hai grit, salts and metals. So that was the third source of microorganisms in water, and that was sewage. The fourth type of sources of microorganisms in water is decaying organic matter. Plants and animals, these are actually the main sources of dead and decaying organic material in soil. That is, after the death of plants and animals, their bodies, these are decomposed by different types of microorganisms present in soil, and that's why they act as a main source of that dead and decaying organic material. There are different types of saprophytic bacteria. Saprophytic means here which can grow on dead and decaying organic material. So there are different types of saprophytic bacteria, molds, yeast, the actinomycetes and protozoa are present and they grow on such dead and decaying organic matter. And finally, these microorganisms, they enter into the surface water. So the dumping of organic waste near water bodies, they add many microorganisms in surface water and therefore it is very essential to avoid this dumping of waste near the water bodies so we can prevent the contamination of that water. That is the fifth source of microorganisms in water and that is nothing but human and animal activities. So there are different types of activities of humans such as swimming, then washing of clothes as well as animals, they add microorganisms in water. And that pathogens from intestine which comes along with fecal matter and the microorganisms which are coming from the surface of skin, they get added in water and they act as a sources of infection. Therefore, to prevent the contamination of water, it is very essential to avoid these human activities which can add microorganisms in water. And if we avoid these human activities, if we up to certain limit, so we can automatically prevent the contamination of water from these microorganisms. See, this is the diagram which shows the human activities. Here, that different types of human activities, they are actually responsible for the addition of microorganisms in surface water. See, these are the children here. They add, that is that fecal matter, it get mixed with sewage here. And if that pipelines of drinking water, these are leaked, so these microorganisms, pathogenic microorganisms from this fecal matter, they get added in the drinking water supply. Then bathing in the rivers or lakes, they also add microorganisms from these microorganisms. Then washing of these cloths here, then swimming. So these are the different human activities. They add microorganisms in the that water or in surface water. So in this way, we have seen that 2 points in this today's lecture. That first point was that is types of water and second point was that is nothing but the sources of microorganisms in water. Now in next lecture, we are going to see that is index of water pollution and then we will see different indicator microorganisms including coliform bacteria. तो यहाँ पे हमने दो टॉपिक पॉइंट हमने कवर किए हैं. जो पहला पॉइंट था हमारा दैट इज टाइप्स ऑफ वाटर एंड सेकंड पॉइंट था सोर्सेस ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स इन वाटर. और अभी नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में हम कवर करेंगे इंडेक्स ऑफ वाटर पोल्यूशन एंड उसके बाद हम कवर करेंगे डिफरेंट इंडिकेटर माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स इंक्लूडिंग दैट कोलिफॉर्म बैक्टीरिया. सो थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो एंड वी विल मीट इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. थैंक यू.